No, just one thing to keep in mind, like, unlike what Anaya just said about if you have something that you want to, like, show off, that's great, Anaya, and we'll gladly deal with that sort of thing, but you have to kind of make sure that it's also worth the time and, like, the time to talk about. Like, you have to also provide a little bit of content, like, your reason for showing it off, your reason for doing it, and not just, oh, look what I did. I made this cool picture. I want to go on the Sourcecast to announce it and have nothing for us to really, like, think about or discuss about.
Yeah.
Kind of like what Skull was talking about here, or when we had Dragon Tamer earlier before. We had reasons to talk about. There was things that, there was fan fictions, there was the content, and then there was also the reasons for leading up to the content, and reasons for like expectations and people's reactions already that we've already seen before. Just discussions. We need material that's also able to start discussions like that.
Exactly. So, yeah, again, I'm just going to reiterate, pretty much, it's if you've got something new to add to the discussion, especially, or any discussion, or some profound thought that nobody really has ever had before, send it to us. That would make a great discussion topic. And
it doesn't have to be just fanfics. You could be a fan artist, you could be a game book designer, you could be anything, and it doesn't have to just be Falsa Source either. Lion King Source, Spirit Source, All Dark Source, you could
right.
be anywhere, anything, but please just try to give us something to actually...
And this is for being a guest speaker. Don't feel like we're not accepting anybody's request. If you really, really want to say, if you really want to advertise what you're doing, go ahead and send it to the mailbag. We'll gladly read it out loud on the show for you to announce that you're doing something or whatnot.
That just fits more in the shout out area.
Yeah.
I think the only other thing I have to add to that is the list of people who had asked formally to join as guest speakers in some way and talk about some things. Raging Balto, Kone. Is it Kone or Kone?
I've never been able to pronounce that correctly.
I always said it Kone, like Tony, but Kone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, hopefully we'll have him to correct us on that.
Yeah, you know who you are.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Axel and Ohura Werewolf, I know you sent me a PM about some topics to talk about. I haven't gotten to look through those in its entirety, and I haven't gotten to send any suggestions back. I'm really, really sorry. I'll do that soon, I promise. But pretty much anybody else who would like to do stuff. I know Tailspan also had said something about that, but we didn't really hash any of that out very well. I'll get there eventually when my brain's fine. Moving right along.
We don't
really have a whole lot of interesting fan news this week.
No, but we do have one special occasion. We do got...
Oh, that's right. Swords'
yep.
birthday is next week.
Yeah. It's actually Friday, but it's cool.
So this Friday, right?
Yeah.
This Friday?
This week, it's October 1st.
Oh.
Oh, wow. So it's like tomorrow.
So
tomorrow.
Yeah, like 12:30 a.m.
Yeah, okay. Well, then I got that wrong. It's this week.
Yeah, well, hey.
Because, again, my brain is broken.
Happy birthday to you, Swords.
Swords' birthday is on Friday. Send him a PM saying happy birthday.
Thank you.
If you have something you want to give him, you're going to have to ask him for
his picture.
Yeah. See, now... This section is typically for everybody else that we notice that have a birthday in a particular month, but that's really hard for us to even catch. So this is another reason for you guys to contact us through the mailbag. Send us your birthdays if you want them announced.
Send your best friend's birthday so we can announce it, and you know he'll feel special.
Yeah, and not only that, please let me know if you would like me to try and continue writing down all the birthdays, or if you want me to go by the birthday topic that's in the other section of the forums, because that's supposed to have a lot more of the active people's birthdays, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't have all of them. Yeah. Let me know what you want me to do.
Yeah, please. Anything to help us.
The only problem I really have with it is if I don't manage to get on for one day and I miss all of the birthdays, they're gone if I just can't get on for one reason or another during that 24-hour period.
Yeah.
And I can't go back and retrieve the names from the bottom of the forum. So, hey, maybe that's a way
you
guys can contribute to the Sourcecast. Anybody want to write down birthdays for me?
And if you don't send in your birthdays, we're just going to probably omit this section altogether.
Yep.
And we don't want to do that. We like all our sections.
We do.
Yeah.
We like saying happy birthday to all of you who really like to hear happy birthday live in front of hundreds, if not thousands, of people. So if you want to hear us say happy birthday to you, write in my birthday is this date, see if it works into your podcast. So,
yep.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Now on to the mailbag. So you always have our question for the mailbag. We asked you last time what was your favorite April Fool's prank, and we didn't get any answers. Come on, people. We were gone for, 6 months, people. Come on.
Ample time.
Ample time.
Ample time for you guys to
send
answers.
You guys failed. You guys lost the game.
Again.
Yeah.
Come on.
That's
believe me.
For anybody who's keeping score.
So, make up for your missed opportunity, we're going to pose you a question right now. And we thought it would be cute in the spirit of things to ask you how many of you thought that Skull was a girl when you first knew him. So, and as always, email it to sourcecast@gmail.com or post it on our forum topic in the other section.
And
so...
And we also have a secondary question.
How many of you, other than Rusty, Anayu, and me, thought Skull was a girl until he got on the Sourcecast?
Or earlier.
Yeah, no idea how fun that was.
Yeah.
And I enjoyed every minute of it. I still enjoy every minute of it.
So we've also got another question to ask to also give you a second double opportunity, because we really want input.
See?
And also, in the spirit of things, since it's almost October... What are you dressing up as for this Halloween? And if you're not dressing up, what's your favorite costume to see or wear or use or costume concept? Anything.
Yeah,
what's your favorite costume overall?
Or what costume would you really like to see that you've never seen before?
Yes.
Yes.
That's
stuff like that.
Now, remember, just send your answers to the sourcecast@gmail.com and we'll very likely read it out loud. Because we have pretty much
posted on our forum topic in the other section.
And either way, we will make sure to read it out loud the next Sourcecast.
If you really want to, you can PM it to one of us.
That works too.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
We're desperate for input.
Just any input we can get will be fine. You want feedback.
So that'll be it for the mailbag. You just have. We just need things to read, so... Get working on that. We need your stuff.
Yeah.
Also working, as we've also said before, we're also working on we're working on getting a live feed Sourcecast going.
Oh, yes.
But considering that we're all in different locations, that's not going to be terribly easy. But we're working on it.
We're working on
it. So bear with us.
We were almost there. We just... still having a lot of technical issues with it, so it's still there. Anyways, why don't we just right now go ahead and lead ourselves out with the conclusions.
All right.
Once again, thank you for listening in on this episode, and thank you so much for being so patient with us as actually getting this episode out, and also dealing with me and my foxiness is when I did that joke episode.
Rusty, you're very foxy.
Arr. Foxy. Oh, hey. We don't need another person being
that was
by
that crossed the line.
I'm sorry.
So I'm going to quickly just say the contact information and whatnot. So we are the Sourcecasters. You can find us mainly at the Animation Source and the forums. You can contact us by emailing us to you can email us at sourcecast@email.com. You can
email.
Oh my god. Listen, it's way too late. Okay, I want to say that again. You can email us at sourcecast@gmail.com. You can also... Wait, I didn't say it wrong, did I?
No, you got it right. That's
See, you can also... You can also PM each of us on the forums. We're also working on our website called... Our website at www.sourcecast.webs.com. And you can also find... You can find the podcast itself at mypodcast.com, at the iTunes store, and you can find us in this show in sections on YouTube. And I'm sorry, that's completely completely long-winded, and I'm out of breath.
Speaking of YouTube, another promotional idea I've had that I would like input on from other people is, do you want us to host you in our subscription boxes for different episodes? Like, we could have a challenge, like whoever answers the question first gets hosted in the subscription box so people will subscribe to your channel or can check out your videos and therefore, you know, give you some more looks and subscribers. Throwing that out there, something like that.
Yeah, you could tell we're desperate for feedback.
Right.
So to end, thank you so much and so long, and thanks for all the fish.
Yes.
So says the notes.
Yes.
Anyways.
So long, and thanks for all the fish.
Good night, Animation.
Good
source.
Night. So, this is the Sourcecast, and I'm Rusty.
I'm Anayu.
I'm Swords.
And I'm Skablaka.
Good night, guys.
Thanks for listening. Good night.
So long, and thanks for all the fish.
Peace out.
See you guys. Now, guys, I'm going to do a review of Balto 2. I'm trying to start off a web show that reviews furry-themed movies. And I figured that this would be of interest to you because a lot of you guys are fans of Balto. And if any of you guys have seen The Nostalgia Critic, that's kind of what I'm going for. And on that note, I want to just point out a little disclaimer. Despite the very angry tone that you will hear me having in this brief portion of my review, just know that I do not, that does not reflect my actual views of Balto 2. I'm trying, it's an act, the anger is an act, and mostly I'm just looking for stuff to make fun of, and then I make fun of it because it can be made fun of. So, just thought I'd get that out of the way so nobody starts hating me for it. So, just make sure everyone's okay with that before I start this. So, anyway, I watched Balto 2, and so, little background about it. It was made by Universal Animation Studios in lieu of Amblimation's generally going out of business. And it handled all of these animated sequels to the animated movies that Amblimation did, such as Balto, for instance. What generally happened is that all these sequels, which were most often direct to video, paled in comparison to the originals. And of the three movies in the Balto trilogy, Balto 2 is generally viewed as the worst of the three, with the first one being the best. Why? Well, let's start out with a few things about it. First off, the voice actors. According to an interview a fan managed to arrange with the director, Phil Weinstein,